My husband and I have really spent some time thinking about what the 5-year goal is. So in a five-year goal for Handyman Connection of Golden is to be a $2 million business that can be run by someone else. And if we don't feel that it could be run by someone else, that we would sell it for a profit. You as a business owner have to realize that you bought this business to work on the business and not in the business. You didn't buy a job, you bought a business. And the faster that you can get into that mindset after opening, the more successful that you'll be. So where when I opened, I was handling things to make sure that they went smoothly. So now an issue pops up, I'll take a look at it, and I'm sending a service log in our system to one of my CSRs and telling her, hey, I would do X, Y, and Z. If that doesn't work, call me. Because I'm training her to take over my business. And that's what a business owner does.
Expansion is a possibility for us. We have the current growth and everything. We have a two to three year plan that at some point we will probably continue to expand our portion of the franchise further into Kansas to where we're buying other parts of Kansas, other areas. And that's mine and my wife's overarching goal is to be able to do that. And we're able to do that with the Handyman Connection franchise.
Third year is when you start to make real money. That's obviously a critical goal we're not in this for charity. We're in this to run a business and make money. And the first 2 years are lean and mean. You are building a business as an investment. And so my ultimate goal in the medium term is where I'm at right now is to set up a business that generates cash flow that pays for me to run my business. And that's where we're at right now. With the help of our coach, we put together our latest AFP, which is an annual financial plan, and that really maps out for us what the next year looks like from a profitability perspective, because at the end of the day, it's ultimately about making money. And so my goal is in the medium term is to build the business up and get it to a place where it's supporting me and my family in the way that I see as appropriate. My ultimate goal is in 5 to 10 years, somewhere in that window, is to sell the business. And if I'm able to drive the kind of financial value out of the business that I think is there, then that means that ultimately I'll be able to sell it. I'll be able to sell it for hopefully a good profit to myself so that I not only made money when I was running the business, but that this is going to support me as I move into the next stage of my life.
I know a lot of owners have ambitions of selling someday. That might be on the radar for me, but I want to build a $50 million business. We did $1.1 million in revenue, and I don't know that it's all through Handyman Connection. I know that I have access to 80 to 100 homes every week in the summer, and I know that, at least I believe that real estate is one of the safest investments and, in many cases, the most profitable. So I have this team of people who can fix real estate, and I have access to a lot of real estate, and now I have my real estate license. So as far as an exit strategy, if I sell it, I think I would still want to be involved. I think I would want to continue to work in some type of consulting fashion or maybe maintain equity. But long term, I want to build an empire that flips homes and gives craftspeople the opportunity, a shot at real wealth, because a lot of these guys have worked $20, $30 an hour their whole life, and a 401k is a dream, and I want to give them an opportunity for so much more than that. I think we need to have those traditional retirement plans, but what I'd really like to see is a craftsperson who can tell a story about how he used to make $20, $30 an hour and now has 6 properties, and yeah, he has his 401k, but he can retire and he's getting paid every month, you know? He's not living on a budget. So that's what I would like to create. And then if I have to sell it someday, it's just such an asset, you know? You have a whole team of people who can fix houses, and until they make houses that fix themselves in 300 years, I think we're gonna be a very necessary industry.
23 years ago, when I was first involved with the business, we used to kind of check the phones to make sure they were working. Fast forward 23 years, and we've just grown so much. We've seen a lot of growth in our business, and we're really happy with that. And we know that there's still more growth that we can have. So we're excited to continue to be a part of the team.
My goals is just to continue to, you know, I believe it's a simple goal, is, you know, mine is to continue to grow our business into a profitable business where everyone that works with us benefits not only financially, but they're also happy coming to work. That's our number one goal. And as we go through this business, you know, we'll have basically possibly two extra goals. One of them is that if we develop the business where it can run smoother without us, then we might just maintain it to continue to generate cash and be able to hire a general manager that manages it for us, and we just kind of oversee it. Number one, or number two, you know, we'll make that decision that if we continue to grow it and get the profitability to continue to go up and our sales to go up, you know, then maybe have an exit strategy if the right seller comes aboard and we feel like this, we get the proper offer.